Hi everyone, it's Dina from MilandiLila.com, and tonight I wanted to share a video with you about a flip through of a catalog that I just received in the mail the other day. And I've never received this catalog before, so I thought it was really cool as I was going through it. I love this artist. It's by a specific artist, and her name is Mackenzie Childs. She has a very interesting kind of whimsical style, I shall say. And it's just really, really cool, this catalog and all the items inside. It's very inspiring, and I thought that I would share it with you. So let's do this. This is the front cover of the December Mackenzie Childs catalog. And as you can see, her specific style is mainly this type of black and white checked pattern. And she also has like a harlequin pattern, and she does stripes. It's just really, really awesome. And I love these trees. These are like styrofoam trees with buttons and sequins. And these would be so much fun to make. Actually, you could probably DIY these if you wanted to. Dollar Tree sells the cones. And if you had a lot of broken jewelry and stuff like that, you could probably create one yourself. I just recently posted a video, Blast from the Past, where I created an ornament out of packing tape and paper and old pieces of jewelry. So if you caught that video, you got the tutorial, and it was quite a long one, actually. I think it was like 40 minutes, and it's start to finish on how I created it. That was super simple and so much fun. So if you subscribe to my channel, you can actually go through the community section feed, and that video will be posted there as a blast from the past. So I hope you will go ahead and subscribe to catch that video and check out my feed there. I have a lot of other videos as well and different inspirational kind of posts and stuff. But anyhow, this is the front cover of the December Mackenzie Childs catalog. And then we're just going to do like a quick flip through. She has a lot of kitchenware and holiday baking accessories and entertaining accessories available in this catalog. And I love it so much. I'm definitely planning on using some of these images in my junk journals. So it's a little bit difficult to do a flip through, so just bear with me. She has some ornaments, a nativity scene, and a crutch. These cute little Santas and nutcrackers. Look how sweet this is. These are like wooden finials, all decked out to look like her style with the striping of candy canes and the black and white. You can see my little, I'm going to move this so you can see. This is Eowyn. Isn't she precious? She loves to sleep on this portion of the couch. Okay, look at this. This is just exquisite. All of these beautiful deer in her famous checked pattern or boxy, whatever you want to call it. I don't know if she has a name for it. Courtly check is, okay, that's what she calls it. It's called courtly check. That is her verbiage for that particular pattern. Can you imagine having a mantle that's all stone like that? It'd be so beautiful. Maybe some of you do that are watching this video. That's just so beautiful. And then just some Christmas packaging with ornaments. It's so hard to do with one hand, you guys. Maybe I should turn like this. That might be a little bit easier. I am so excited about the holidays coming. Are you? Leave me a comment below and let me know if you have your tree up already. We just got our tree up. I'm still working on my mantle altar. I haven't gotten that done yet. I always like to have it ready before Yule. Definitely. It's always available before Christmas to, you know, or available. It's always decorated before Christmas, but I like to get it done before Yule so I can really enjoy it for as long as I can. Look at those trees. They're so beautiful. And again, the courtly checked enamelware, ribbons as well, holiday pillows. Cute little table accessories, candles. She even has, these are carpets. So nice. I feel like you could emulate this. If I, a long time ago, had made a beautiful, it was like a floor cloth for a dear friend of mine, for her daughter. I was invited to her baby shower. This was so many years ago now. Oh my goodness. I think she's 18 now, her daughter. But when she was, before she was born, I made this beautiful floor cloth with Noah's Ark characters because my friend Mary was going to decorate Jamie Lynn's room with Noah's Ark. So I made a floor cloth out of painter's canvas that you would actually use as a floor cloth, drop cloth kind of piece to put on the floor when you're painting to save your carpet or to save your floor from getting paint. And I used that and created this beautiful, as I call it, a floor cloth that she could have used as like a carpet, like a little rug, an area rug, or a wall hanging. And I think Mary chose to hang it on the wall for a while. And it was so beautiful. I painted it with Noah's Ark characters. And then I also decoupaged fabric of Noah's Ark imagery on it as well. And it came out really well. And this kind of reminds me of that. That is such a beautiful project too, by the way, you guys. I haven't done that in a while, but you know, you never know. I might end up doing something like that again. It was just so much fun and it really came out beautiful. It was just like, it's so much cheaper, first of all, to make it yourself. And it's so much more just beautiful to know that you created it yourself. More of the courtly check. Now I know what that's called. Look at this teapot. So pretty. Oh my. Look at those decorative candles. That is so inspiring to me. There's another one coming up in this catalog that I want to show you that I really want to try to make. I have a white pillar candle and I was thinking about doing something with it and maybe perhaps gifting it to someone if it came, you know, if it comes out nice. If not, I'll keep it. But yeah, so that's just so inspiring. But even this right here, this is like a colander, but it's not a colander. It doesn't have the holes in it, but it's shaped like a colander. And they have it, there's, get rid of the glare. They have champagne bottles in it. So it's kind of like an ice bucket, if you will. It doesn't have a lid or anything that would keep the ice cold, but it, at least it would keep it cold for a while. More teapots, kitchenware. Ah, it's so difficult one-handedly to try to get this. Oh, look at this. This is salt and pepper shakers. Right, wait a minute. Right there. Get that glare out of there. So cute. I love it. And look at that mug. Oh my goodness. I'm absolutely in love with it. Now, I will tell you, if you're not familiar with Mackenzie Childs, look her up. I did read an article once, I think it was in a Victoria magazine, and it was all about Mackenzie Childs. She lives on a boat on either a river. I think it's a river. It's not a lake. It's a river. And I can't remember where, but she lives on a boat, and it's amazingly magical. It's just so cool, and it's obviously all decked out in her style. the napkin holder up there. Oh, that is just adorable, as well as the napkins. And look at the plates, the blue and white Courtly Chat. Now it looks like, okay, Courtly Chat is the black and white. And then she has it looks like the blue and white is called Royal Check. Maybe I'm wrong. I'm not sure. Yeah. The blue and white is Royal Check, and the black and white is Courtly Check. And I love this right here. This is a tea towel that says Mackenzie Childs, and it's like a stacked situation going on here with the teapot and the teacups. So cute. I think I was saying that Mackenzie Childs artistry is kind of expensive, but if you're a collector and you love her things and you have the finances in your budget to purchase, then I would say go for it because it's just really beautiful. Here's an example. They're calling it Bowled Over. Let's see if I can find it. No, I can't find it. So I'm going to tell you about this one right here. This is called the Everything Bowl. Everything Bowl. That is what you saw earlier in the Courtly Check with the champagne bottles. It's $120, you guys, for that. So it's a little expensive, but you know what? It's just so pretty. And like I said, if you're a collector, go for it because it's beautiful. If you have the finances. So again, here's the different colored check patterns. I think we're coming up to the candles. And this is a little bit more Christmassy inspired. Oh, look at this. Okay. High Banks Travel Cup, $32. I guess that's not really totally out of range. And that has a Christmas scene on it. It's really pretty. I think we're coming to the candles. Okay, so here's a penguin. It's like an accessory that you can put on your counter. And plates, once again. And then there's another pattern of plates that's like a charger. And that is, let's see, snowfall placemat. Oh, it's a placemat. And one of them is $35. A little pricey, but again, okay, yeah, here it is. Okay, you guys. First of all, here's these trees again in like a gold. So gorgeous. So gorgeous. My face. Excuse my face, like right in the screen. But look at these candles right here. I absolutely love that. I think that would be so easy to emulate using paint. And maybe even like brads that you could stick into the wax of the candle. Now, I would be really careful if you used paint and burning it. I've never really tried painting a candle before, so you might want to do a little bit of research to see if it's burnable once it's painted. But sometimes candles just decoratively look gorgeous and don't need to be burned. They're just so pretty as is on occasion. To decorate your mantle or a tablescape or whatever. So yeah, look at this. This is like the white and gold Christmas. And look how sweet these are. These are little ornaments. They're cars, vintage cars. So cute. And then over here, these are vintage, they're like mercury glass. Yeah, they're glass ornaments. So sweet. And as I said, These pages in here, some of this imagery are so cute for journaling. Every single year, if you guys have followed my channel, you know that I create a Christmas holiday memories journal. This particular year, I'm going to be doing a file folder Christmas style journal, and I am super excited about it. I have a workshop that I'm going to be, a local workshop that I'm going to be doing, teaching how to create, I moved that with my leg, how to create the file folder journals. And that's probably going to be coming in January. So if you are local, message me and let me know if you're interested in joining us. I have a few people already signed up for it. I am currently, depending on how many more people we get, I may need to change the space as to where I'm going to be holding the workshop. So like I said, if you're local, just message me and let me know. If you're not local, I am doing instructionals this year for 2020 on different projects, and I will be setting my instructionals up for purchase on a website. And I will release all of that information a little bit later into 2020 as I get all of that situated. So if you are not local and you'd still like to take a workshop or a class of some sort, you know, I guess technically speaking, classes are those that you can take online, and classes are those that you can take in person. Workshops, I don't know if there's really a difference, to be honest with you. I kind of feel like a workshop is a gathering place where people get together and they work on things together, whereas a class is more of where you have a teacher and the teacher is teaching you how to do something. Whereas a workshop, it's a little bit more, you still have a teacher, but it's a little bit more hands-on. So I guess technically speaking, if I'm going to be sharing it online, depending on the platform, it may be a workshop where I am kind of doing it with you and you would be doing it with me. Excuse me, my nose is itchy. Or it may be a class where I'm just giving you the instructional and showing you how to do it. I haven't decided yet. I have to look into the site where the platform where I would be placing my instructionals before I can tell you exactly what I'm going to call it. But that is just a matter of technicality, you guys. Regardless, you're going to learn something new. That's really what it's all about. But I thought, long story short, you know, I'm so long-winded. some of the imagery from this catalog is definitely going to be used in my holiday file folder portfolio or journal, whatever I decide to call it. But it will be a memory of the season, and these images are so cute. So I will be doing a lot of fussy cutting and using some of them. Now, look at this. Is that not adorable, that wreath? Look at that. So cute. And I love this little stool with this fluffy throw. I have one of these, you guys. Mine's pink, though. I got it for my daughter, Nikki, for my birthday so many years ago, probably about, I don't know, 2 or 3 years ago now. And I absolutely adore it. I have to sleep with it every night. It's so cozy. It's like a weighted blanket to me. It's so warm and cozy. And it's just like being hugged. It's just so nice. I love it. But anyways, that is the last of the catalog. And let me. I'm trying to hide my address there. That is the back of the catalog. So cute with the Santa. Yeah, the Santa and his tree and the little train. So adorable. So that, my lovely, beautiful souls, is the flip through of the Mackenzie Childs Holiday December 2019 Christmas catalog. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope you found it inspirational. If you didn't know who Mackenzie Childs was, and I just turned you on to this artist, check her out. I think you'll love her and all of her things. Thanks for being here tonight. If you enjoyed this video, please give it the thumbs up. It lets me know that you enjoyed this flip through and flip throughs in general, and it also greatly helps my channel. If you have not yet subscribed, I would love for you to subscribe and join the tribe. Hit that little bell as well so that you are notified every single time I post a video. It will be directly delivered to your personal inbox every time that I post. And with all of that being said, I wish you so much love, so many blessings, and so many friendships to come. I appreciate you all so much for being here and for all that you do. And I just love you all so much. Thank you. Mwah. Bye.